Hello and welcome back, everyone. Today is Sunday, the 28th of November, and I'm joined here with Michael in Germany with his Science is the New Religion script, session 75. Michael, so good to be here with you today.
Yeah, hello, Brett, and hello, dear listeners out there. I don't know where you have tuned in from, the United States or Canada or England or Australia or New Zealand, India, I don't know. Yeah, we have done 74 sessions so far, and it's not that I'm out of any ideas, but I have to find some things so that we connect the science of the 19th century, 20th century to the modern situation here. So I don't want to go into the atom bomb or all the things, because it makes no sense, actually, because there is not much to it. We don't know anything for certain, so we have to use our common sense, that we shall be not blinded by science. So this is session 75, and I thought I just talk about a little bit last time of Nikola Tesla, Albert Einstein, about the ether and all the things coming up. So you see that I know that is a Brussels, capital city of Belgium, and this is the atomium model of an atom, which is not an atom. Huh? Does an atom look like this? No, huh? But you see that where to start? Where to start? You see, the people are science is the new religion, or science is the new god. We should also have called the sessions, I think. Okay, so then let's move on. In the United States, it's been said that every law not based on wisdom is a menace to the state. But what is wisdom? So, yeah, schade. What is wisdom? Wisdom. Yeah. Wisdom just means knowledge, learning, experience. The problem is that we have not been taught the correct science. So therefore, this is a futile argument, because everybody thinks about wisdom. They think that's something else. And they think that there is just one science. And in science, everybody agrees, which is not the case. That's the result of more or less 450 or almost close 500 years of Jesuit conspiracy, if you want to like to point it out. And what you see here is actually a system of the solar system. Interesting, I found that in that video, the depiction of the so-called solar system with the sun apparently here, seems to play a big important role. Mm-hmm. Yeah, coming back to all the things that we have to deal with Jesuitical science. And many people claim that there is the Black Pope on top of the Jesuit Council or the Jesuit Provincials, and the White Pope or the Papacy and all the Catholic knighthoods. What's correct in that picture is that on top of the pyramid or the hierarchy in that regard is Satan. And that's a big difference to many, many, many pages and many, many authors, many, many people who just actually believe that this world has been run by regular people with their own hands. And they don't apply to the idea that we have all been created by a spirit, and they don't apply to the idea that we are spiritual beings. Well, where comes the inspiration, huh? Where does the inspiration of Albert Einstein come from? This is where we received the citizenship here, for example, so that everybody thinks that this more or less actor, which was a very intelligent actor, by the way, that this actor actually is one of the big masterminds. But the masterminds behind the scene, you do not see. Coming back to Nikola Tesla. The tragic story of Nikola Tesla in that video tells that on 8 minutes and 8 seconds, Tesla willingly walked away from about $12 million in royalties, which in today's term, we do not want to know how much money that would be. So I think that money was not his big issue. I think that his big issue was that he was convinced about his ideas, and he was studying Jesuitical science. So that means that we have talked about him extensively in the last session. Why do I bring him up here once again? Well, you see that Tesla has been also been mentioned with the water power and renewable energy and etc. etc. So that I think is also serves him a place in history, especially when you think about the Elon Musk electric mobiles or automobiles. Automobile means actually driving on its own. It's automatic. Automatic mobility. And I think that will be soon approaching, that the cars will steer and drive for themselves and people just can enter the desired location. And if the state or an authority overrules and said, no, 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 you don't go to the barbecue because you are too overweight, then you got a problem. But that is more or less, I think, the future, that state government legislation authorities in the digital world will have a big, big, big saying in what you are allowed to do and what you are not allowed to do. And it's so hilarious that even the most famous professors in Germany, for example, this Jesuitically trained Professor Harald Lesch says, of course, there is no ether. Yeah, he has to tell that to people because the people are mostly superficial and don't agree and don't know anything and just believe everything that comes out of that vision from far away, which means the television. Hmm? Also, there is, interesting enough, it's an etherous society. Hmm? So there is much things going on about the etherous society. And if I would go down that path, you would be extremely biased against this session, I think, because you see that there are so many people coming up with so many theories in the occult. And this is here mentioned on Dr. Stephen Skinner on Nostradamus. Now, this is an excerpt of the book, and you cannot imagine, as a Bible-believing Christian, you cannot imagine how deceived these people are thinking of themselves to be wise, Romans 1:22. Yeah, there are doctors, there are professors, they are so high up in the hierarchy of this satanic world, and the higher you are up in the hierarchy, Brett, it's quite logical, the more you must be away from the real word of God.
That's right, Michael. You cannot serve two masters.
Yeah.
It says right in scripture, man cannot serve two masters.
Mm-hmm. You cannot imagine how deceived these people are. In 1954, 8 days after he had heard a mysterious voice telling him that he had been chosen as a spokesman of the so-called Interplanetary Parliament, unquote, a certain George King was shaken to the core by the miraculous appearance of a figure dressed in white robes and looked like an Eastern saint. The apparition told him that he had been selected to act as the servant of the cosmic masters. Thus, the Aetherius Society was born, although King would not formally constitute it until 1960. So 6 years later. Soon King was holding public meetings. At these, he would put on a pair of dark glasses and go into a trance to make contact with the communicating entity, often from Mars or Venus. Typically, the information passed through King would include movements of flying saucers, fleets, and also the advance of such terrestrial disasters in hurricanes and earthquakes. These upheavals in the natural world were thought to herald the new spiritual order which beings like the Master Aetherius are attempting to bring to Earth, very much in the manner of the second coming of Christ. The Latin word Aetherius means relating to the ether or to the abodes of the gods. Interesting, huh? Ether, relating to the ether or to the abodes of the gods. That's why I came up with last time and said that it's just spirit. Or divine spirit. Or spirit of the so-called god of this world. However you would like to see it. There are certain spirits. During one or two in the early public meetings held by King in 1955, the Master Aetherius mentioned that Jesus Christ was living on Venus, along with other religious leaders such as Buddha and Ramakrishna. The Star of Bethlehem was said to be a flying saucer which had brought Jesus to Earth for his first incarnation, press, ridicule, and ensured sell-out performances. On July the 23rd of 1958, King claimed to have met with the avatar of Jesus Christ on Holstone Down in the west of England. As a result of this meeting, King made a practice of visiting the so-called high places of the world and charging them with spiritual energy. So, ether means relating to gods, to the abodes of God. Didn't we go into abundance yesterday, Brett?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. You see, we're not very far away from divine, let's say, divine intervention, okay? Can also be spiritual intervention. It must not be necessary to be divine. Everything is possible as long as the Almighty God does allow it. So also devils can do so-called miracles, but it's just for the deception of people, and they can do some things as long as God is allowing them to. And then, therefore, you would have to read the book of Revelation to think about the things. Yeah. So what science in the 20th century and the 21st century? Actually, it is just the beginning of the end, I'd say. It's the beginning of the end in terms of the thinking of the New Age, Enlightenment, Aquarius Age, blah, 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 blah. So that people think themselves they can create everything and they can do everything and they are not bound to any commandment, to any God, to any religion at all. So that is pure lust. That is pure power, pure self-consciousness. Yeah. So people are looking not for the truth, but is with Jesus Christ, people are looking for self-enlightenment. Yeah, that's
self-empowerment, Mike.
Self-empowerment, yeah. Yeah.
That's what you're thinking.
Yeah, so that Christianity is on its way out. Yeah, people became hypnotized by Satan's power religion because they were not grounded in God's ethics religion. Yeah, that's it, actually. In a nutshell. If you are in the occult, if you are in any secret order, if you're in any secret society, you don't follow the order of God, you follow the order of the society. And if society says this is correct, then there are other certain rules to follow, but not the rules of God. This is the first page of a book called Unholy Spirits. I got this book in my possession, at least in a copy. And it's Gary, I have forgot the name of that, but it's been here including a very fine information and explanation why the situation out there had become that way. That's in the 60s. Satan's power religion. That is the creation of Satanism, Satanic Church, the free love, and 90 spirit of 69, and all the stuff. Drugs on a high account for many, many drugs, and techno scene, and all the free love thing, then the gender agenda, and all the things. It just working out that is. It must be the opposite to the Bible. That's the only term. It must be the opposite to the Bible. The author says, I have retitled it Unholy Spirits, Occultism and New Age Humanism. I had not used the term New Age in the original book, though I was familiar with the term. It has long been in common phrase in occult circles. The term is now well known in Christian circles, so I have adopted it in this version. The basic theme of the book is simple enough and has not changed since I wrote it. In the rise of the occultism as a cultural force in the United States began around 1965 and paralleled the rise of the counterculture and the breakdown of the older establishment humanism, the can-do pragmatism, which was apotheosized posthumously as Kennedy's Camelot. Kennedy's death on November 22nd, of course, 1962, was in fact the death rattle of the older rationalism. Interesting, the man who in our day best understood the devil and his kingdom, C.S. Lewis, also died that day, as did Aldous Huxley, grandson of Thomas Huxley, Darwin's first great promoter. Three important people died on November 22nd.
That's really strange.
That's really strange. Yeah, but the world is a stage.
Yes.
Yeah, the world is a stage. That was coming from the book Unholy Spirits. So we know that it's all been planned. It's all been planned from the Jesuits from the beginning. So if somebody serves the Jesuitical agenda, he will be promoted like Albert Einstein or as Edwin Hubble or as Georges Lemaître, etc. Yeah, but if somebody is not promoting it by having some other conclusion, yeah, he will be not of use. So that will grant him no big prizes or big money. Yeah? So that is the problem here, that there are so many people around and we do not consider who's right and who's wrong. Yeah? So that when we go back to the pendulum and all the things, then we know that certain things are serving certain agendas. Yeah. So and now that all the world is deceived by their science, they can do the next step. The next step is controlling the weather. There is a quote from the former United States President Lyndon B. Johnson of 1962, in the time when he was the vice president after John F. Kennedy, and he says, quote, "He who controls the weather will control the world," unquote. Yeah. And who controls the world? Could dimming the sun help to cool the earth? Bill Gates wants to spray millions of tons of chalk into the stratosphere to reflect sunlight and so slow global warming, but critics fear it could be disastrous. Please compare the two headlines. He who controls the weather will control the world. Bill Gates wants to dim the sun. And I'm absolutely certain why he wants to dim the sun. Because it is written, I think it is in Matthew 24, if I remember correctly. You know, that to be successful, there must be in the Antichrist spirit and they must act according to the Bible. Oh, where is it? I have not prepared it properly. Yeah, oh, here is it. Okay, in Matthew 24:29, Brad.
Yes.
Would you care to read?
Yes. It reads, immediately after the tribulation of those days shall the sun be darkened and the moon shall not give her light, and the stars shall fall from heaven and the powers of the heavens shall be shaken.
Yeah, so maybe they got this in mind, that they tried to fulfill the prophecies on their or with their means, you see. Why should somebody darken the sun? You see that somebody darkens the sun because he can do it. Yeah, so he can play God. He can, yeah, he can switch out the light, actually. It's just a hint. I don't go to this and I say, okay, this is engraved in stone. Yeah, but you see, I came up with the idea that they want to play God. So they have to do everything according into the Antichrist spirit to fulfill scripture in the Antichrist spirit. So they are about to be the servants of Satan on earth and causing as much destruction as they can. So if somebody would actually go for darkening the sun, it would have the effect, and they will succeed in that, that would be the effect that the harvest will not be there and that it's we're getting very cold and energy loss of all the solar panels, which then we would be very much useless. And so. Yeah. So if you try to rapture nature, I think we will discover a much more bigger problem afterwards. But this is just here from newspaper dailymail.co. Bill Gates wants to spray millions of tons of chalk. I don't know what they are spraying, but I know that it is no coincidence. Absolutely no coincidence that it is A, Bill Gates, and B, it is to darken something. Yeah, that would be in the line of the Bible, and that would actually mean that these people have an agenda, which you don't want them to have. Mm-hmm. So that is the idea. to darken the sun. Actually, to go into the weather manipulation is not a new artifact. Weather manipulation. And we look to Russia with Mr. Putin. Yeah, Russia, science alert. Okay. Russia spent millions on cloud seeding tech to prevent rain on its public holiday. You might consider bad weather on a public holiday to be a simple twist of meteorologic fate, but the Russian government is determined to do something about it. This is from 2016, with reports stating that it spent the equivalent of $1.3 million to prevent rain on their May 1st public holiday. Ah, May 1st, the old Celtic day, the feast of fertility, huh?
A pole thing, yeah.
What a coincidence, yeah? Known locally as International Workers' Day. Yeah, they sell it as this also in Germany. It's a day for the worker, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It sounds like a bunch of hokum. Well, it might be, but weather manipulation technologies are becoming more advanced and more reliable with each passing year. While cloud seeding in particular is getting a lot of attention with all the variables involved, it's difficult to prove that it's definitely working, but that's not enough to stop anyone from giving it a shot. Oh, to give it a shot. Interesting. Normally, silver iodide, potassium iodide, and solid carbon dioxide, dry ice, are the most commonly used chemicals in cloud seeding, though details are sketchy regarding how the job was done in Russia. The cocktail of substances can be deployed by rocket or plane and is intended to cause water droplets to grow and fall to ground. So, in other words, you stop the clouds to rain when you approach them in a distance, and you force them to rain so that there are no clouds left. So that means a sunny sky, of course. No clouds left means sunny sky. Russia isn't the first to give it a go. The Chinese authorities previously used cloud seeding to keep conditions dry at the opening ceremony for the Beijing Olympics in 2008. In that case, 1,110 rockets were fired into the sky over the period of several days. The bird's nest in Beijing stayed dry, but it was by pure chance or a consequence of the cloud seeding, it's hard to say. China is believed to have more people employed in the business of weather modification than any other nation. Still, even experts in the field have no idea how to actually tell whether the storm was a result of seeding or simply happened on its own. You see what this is here? This is not the thing which actually is been broadcasted over ABC, CNN, CBS or what else. But if you look upon it, you see there are many things in science that we are absolutely not aware of, and for strange reasons. Strange reasons. And there's much more strange things coming up. For example, this website, or this PDF actually, weather as a force multiplier, owning the weather in 2025. A research paper presented to the Air Force in August 1996, so that is more or less a prophecy, this is more or less a forecast for a time period of about 29 years. And now we are approaching 2022. So if there is an earthquake outside, or if there is a tide, or if there is heavy rain, storm, lightning, what else you can expect? Are you really sure that this is the weather, or is there somebody testing and experimenting, like the Russians, like the Chinese, like the, oh, wait, the Air Force? Mm-hmm. What does the Bible say in chapter 24? It does also say there will be coming up here, look at that, earthquakes. So, we know about the atomic event in Fukushima in Japan some years ago, which happened when a big earthquake supposedly was happening in the middle of the ocean, and then there was a tide and so many things, and then some nuclear plant was exploding there, and so there was a certain location, certain area around the Fukushima power station that cannot be accessed anymore. Yeah? So that if somebody can control the weather also means there are some thunderstorms and tornadoes and what else. So I'm not quite sure that this is will happening here by accident, or this was happening here like an orchestrated action. It's just that I want to point out some awareness that we cannot know what the enemy is capable of. But if the air force, of course, the air, huh, the weather, rain and moisture, fog, clouds, it's all air. Yeah, it's of course it's not the Marines. They are not responsible for the weather conditions in the sky, but it is the Air Force. Yeah. What does that paper claim? This is a study designed to comply with the directive from the Chief of Staff of the Air Force to examine the concepts, capabilities, and technologies the United States will require to remain the dominant air and space force in the future. Yeah. So we got, we as the Americans got the fine weather, and we let China drown in rain so that their harvest will be gone. Yeah. This would be a geopolitical action against the state to destroy its infrastructure, for example. Yeah, the other way around, think of that, that the United States wanted to shoot a satellite in space, the official mission. And somebody who is controlling the weather would say, oh, no, no, I can't avoid it because in the area of Cape Kennedy, Kennedy once again, of Cape Kennedy, yeah, I will send heavy storm, heavy thunder and storm so they can't take off. Yeah, the weather conditions are that bad. Yeah, it's too much hurricane and it would be unstable. The liftoff would be unstable. So he who controls the weather said Lyndon B. Johnson, and Lyndon B. Johnson has also been engraved in the Space Administration. We will look it up, I think, further on. And he who controls the weather can play God. Presented in 1996, this report was produced in the Department of Defense School Environments of Academic Freedom and in the interest of advancing concepts related to national defense. The views expressed in this report are those of the authors and do not reflect the official policy or position of the United States Air Force, Department of Defense, or the United States government. By the way, do you know who was then developing the internet? It was more or less the Department of Defense. So somebody's interested in your data. And they take absolutely no problem to look into all the data which you are sharing on the internet. This report contains fictional representation of future situations or scenarios. Any similarities to real people or events other than those specifically cited are unintentional and are for purposes of illustration only. This publication has been reviewed by security and police review authorities, is unclassified, and is cleared for public release. So, in other words, this is just the thing that they let you know. Yeah, but we can be quite sure that there is much more to it. Why would we want to mess with the weather? Yeah, because we can.
Because we can.
Yeah. The Global Weather Network, you see that how they try to... What's the purpose of all the satellites out there? Is it really to broadcast signals from one TV station down to Earth, or is there something other to it? They will function when on the Earth the sun has been darkened. Yeah, the satellites, or the so-called satellites, are that high that they are not affected by any weather modifications on the Earth. So they can still receive and transmit. It's absolutely independent system. Yeah, if you are drowning here because of the weather conditions, because of that much rain and moisture here, it is absolutely of no importance to satellites or even to planes, because they are flying way over the clouds. So they are not affected by the weather. Yeah. So who is controlling the weather, like the United States president, for example, if he is on his Air Force One, he is not affected by the weather also. Strange concept, huh? When you are a kind of a small god, you can control the United States, you can control your entire country and even the weather, and you're the supreme being in the moment when you step on the Air Force One. Yeah, you have to not take it literally, but yeah, you see that you can feel yourself enlightened and as a much better and much more important human being than an average worker or a postman or a nurse who's caring for people, who gets less reward, less money, less fame, less support than any politician of the world. Welcome in a satanic system where just pure egoism and pure power is the driven motor for all the action, including every president. And I'm not making any exception. I am deeply into the research of Mr. Kennedy and I make absolutely no exception. Yesterday we had a talk with Daryl Eberhardt and he said that he remembered reading a book about JFK. And JFK thought, as the elected president of the United States, to be the most important figure in the United States. But my, how he was wrong on that. He just visited a meeting of very rich and important businessmen and oil businessmen and managers and so, and they didn't even care when he was entering the room. That's correct, Brett. No, Daryl was mentioned yesterday, yeah? So this is just a concept that people try to play God. Yeah. So to control the weather, to have any advantage over the enemy, artificial weather. Yeah. We cannot go into 35 pages here, but just to let you know where you can start your research. This is an open document. This is in the open. So that means that there is much more behind the scene. Yeah, like a Area 51 in the weather region, I'd say. So this is science. Yeah, they are using science. Yeah, if they use science, this is against people. This is against the so-called enemy. This is not for the benefit of people who are starving. I don't think that the intention of the Air Force, being more or less an aggressive force to officially defend the country, but you see that in the case of Afghanistan and many other countries, I'd say that's not the logical conclusion that they did it for the protection of the United States. But nevertheless, you see that if there is power, it will be misused against the people. And if somebody has the power about the weather control, then you will use it also against the people. So if somebody doesn't want Mexico or what else, an African country, not to have any rain so that people are starving there because they don't have enough to eat, yeah, then they can do that. Or they are about to do that. You see, this is from 1996. So this is the science of 1996. Can you imagine what kind of computer you had in 1996? I think it was Windows 95. And anybody remembers Windows 95? On a 486DX with a coprocessor. I think that 1995 was about the time when the first Pentium came around. And this is a summary of 1995. This is 25 years, or 1996, okay. But nevertheless, 25 years. Yeah. This is absolutely horrible that hidden science is providing, yeah, what our politicians don't talk about actually. Can you remember any politician on the television talking about weather modifications lately? Lately means in the last months or years. It's not a big deal because you see they are not supposed to talk about that. Yeah, they are just putting out scenarios here, but you see that they think they can finish it by controlling the weather in 2025, weather modification. And this is just science. Yeah, you see, they have the ingredients. we have learned about the ingredients here. And that means that it's just a chemical process. But the intention of using a chemical process not for the benefit of man, but for the disadvantage or for the misuse against other nations, that means that people are thinking about letting people die, letting people starve. Or letting, it's just about the victory. The end justifies the means. I didn't want to go into this very elaborately, but you see that the idea actually is that science will be used against people. Yeah? So that was the reason why I started to think about that we go to the modern day and the actual science now, which are we confronted today. We will go about the thing of the weather control. CINC was okay. Yeah, weather force support element, cost effect. You see, they try to make global strategies. Therefore, you have to take everything into account. We do not know how capable these peoples are. Storms, space control, space weather modification. Yeah, you see, to jam the enemy's active and passive surveillance and reconnaissance system. In short, an operational capability to modify the near space environment would ensure space superiority in 2025. There's much thing coming up. No? What was it at the Vatican lately, which is COP26, which should be fulfilled in 2025? These are the dates here. We are living in a very interesting age, not in a very enlightened age. We live in a very dark age.
That's true.
Yeah? But I just want to point it out here. You see that these things are from 1996. Yeah. Anybody's driving a car from 1996? Anybody's using a computer of 1996?
That's funny you mentioned that, Michael. I actually have some software from back then that I have to resort to using for some of my old equipment, believe it or not.
Yeah, me too. I got also all my computers here, but the thing is that it doesn't work nowadays because the development is so rapid, is so increasing. The storage capacities and et cetera.
You can't use it in practical terms, surfing the web or anything like that. But
no,
you might be able to get email from it, maybe, if you can get that to go. But that's maybe about it.
Yeah. You see that people think about everything to play God, to that nature can be modified. Yeah. So coming back to our Bill Gates, you see, he got the possibility, he's got the money, he's got the backup, and he's got the press behind him. Yeah, at least the press. The balloon would take 600 kilos. This, in American terms, about 1,300 pounds of equipment up to the stratosphere. Yeah, 1,300 pounds. Yeah, that's a big load. Yeah, so he's on the smiling side of life at the moment. In this life, of course. No? To have the chalk deflect a portion of sun radiation, stop it from hitting the surface, and cool the planet. Yeah, that's what everybody would like to have, to cool the planet. Yeah.
Interesting choice of words there at the beginning of the sentence, Michael.
Aim of the mission, yeah. that's a Jesuit word, huh?
Yes. Backed by billionaire Bill Gates.
Yeah. The aim of the mission is that the sun is responsible also for vitamin D.
The aim of the Jesuits, backed by billionaire Bill Gates. Isn't that just great?
Yeah, please.
Yeah, isn't that just great? They're going to make the world, it's not possible to grow food anymore, but Bill Gates has the answer. Mm-hmm. He's going to grow food for us.
Yeah.
Anyone seen the movie Soylent Green?
Mm-hmm. You know what year Soylent Green is about?
Mm-hmm.
Huh? I don't know if you know that.
Oh, 70s, 60s, I don't know.
No, 2020. Yeah, okay, but it's just about the year 2022.
Oh, see, 73 is the original movie.
Yeah, but I know it's Charlton Heston, and Charlton Heston has also a coup clearance. So he's got a Secret Service clearance. Charlton Heston is not an ordinary actor. I went into that by when I was looking about Kennedy, and I'm looking about William Cooper, because William Cooper, many William Cooper fans claim, oh God, he's got a coup clearance. That's QMI on his gravestone. Actually, it's QM1 on his gravestone. I have to look it up. William Cooper grave. There it is. Oh, come on. I know it's there.
Geesh, takes a while to find it, huh?
Yeah, there it is. Yeah. It's QM1, not QMI. And QM1 means quartermaster. Yeah, so that is a lower rank. Yeah, but Charlton Heston, who was playing the main role in the movie 2022, or more or less in Soylent Green. The subtitle in German is 2022, the year where people wants to survive. You know, Charlton Heston, he was the one actually in the Ten Commandments playing Moses, parting the sea, Brett. Where we went into when we were talking about Steam video clip of Peter Gabriel, and we were talking about the Ten Commandments with the parting of the sea, and so that very Moses, our Charlton Heston here, has also played the main character, the leading role in Soylent Green, which is about a dystopian thriller film playing in 2022. Because there are too much people in 2022.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. So I know he's got a Q clearance. I don't know if Wikipedia tells you this. I know he's got it. I know that I have it in a German script. Let's go to Secret. Oh, not Secret of the Incas. Oh, he can. After his rise to fame, Heston narrated for highly classified U.S. Armed Forces and Department of Energy instructional films, particularly related to nuclear weapons, and for 6 years Heston held the nation's highest security clearance, or Q clearance. The Q clearance is similar to a Department of Defense or a Defense Intelligence Agency clearance of top secret. And you think that is a normal author, a regular guy? I don't think so.
Weird.
At least I would bet that he had some kind of special knowledge needed for his task. Mm-hmm. So that is the same, not the same, but it's similar to Christopher Lee. So all these just actors, huh? Sure. Yeah, so that is the thing which comes up to us. We shall heavily rely on solar power in the future, but at the same time, the sun is increasing the temperature of the atmosphere, and so the sun has to dim down and to shut off. And what does that tell you? There is no energy left then. If you are not allowed to use coal, if you're not allowed to use oil, if you're not allowed to burn wood because everything affects the CO2 output, yeah, then there's only wind and solar power left. Yeah, also nuclear reactors are not allowed maybe anymore from a certain point. So it's just natural things going on. So power from the water power station, like from the Niagara Falls at the border of Canada and the United States, where the statue of Nikola Tesla is standing, or wind power or solar power. But what if Mr. Bill Gates decides it is necessary to dim down the sun? Yeah, we will have a big trouble in power supply very soon, I guess. If you want to have the right to have power or access to power from the government or from any legal company, which then is been most likely owned by the government, then you must obey. Otherwise, they shoot you direct back to the dark ages in the best way of thinking. So without the sun, in the dark ages, without any electricity. So welcome to the Middle Ages then. Yeah. So the New World Order is the Old World Order. In the Old World Order, you got a castle, you got a big stove, you got a massive amount of woods, you got massive amount of servants, no problem. But the ordinary John Doe, yeah, he's sitting cold in his shed, not allowed to have the comfort and the luxuries of the nobility. Yeah, it's just a two-way society. Either you are in the club or you are not in it. If you are out of the club, you are just enslaved. Yeah, you don't have any rights. They can even rob you of the right to go into the sun. It may sound unbelievable. It's 2021 at the moment, but I'm not guessing that it takes that long that they even try. They do everything for the climate. Yeah. It's just like this little power corrupts absolute. I didn't want to go into a whole session of the weather. I didn't want to do that, but just wanted to use it as a bypass station for other things to come around. But the more I think about it, the more I learn, the more I read, I think it is absolutely possible that this is a major weapon of the elite. Because they say, okay, the government is not responsible. We are so sorry for the bad weather or for the earthquake or for the volcano or for what else? For the destruction of an entire country. Oh, we are so sorry and we try to make welfare and we try to help. We are sending our troops to help. Maybe some of the countries don't want their troops to help. I'm not speaking of a particular country. It can be China, can be India, can be United States, can be everywhere. But he who controls the weather controls the world, Lyndon B. Johnson said in 1962. That means that in 1962, some people were there who said, oh yeah, we are about to try to control the weather. And not in 1996, where you have learned from that research. So even in 1962, that is 60 years ago, they were talking and they were thinking about controlling the weather. Otherwise, that quote of Lyndon B. Johnson, if that is correct, does not make any sense. So sometimes you have to think that they do know much more than they are putting out. Now they control everything, and you see that the internet is a invention of Department of Defense to receive much information about every individual. Yeah. So, itself could unleash a global outbreak of extreme climatic events that might devastate farmland, wipe out entire species, and foster disease epidemics. What do I read here? Can you imagine? You are living in tremendous climate change and climate environment, and you are sick. Yeah? So that affects also your health. Yeah, as I pointed out, the vitamin D output, which has been generated by the sun of a special wavelength, yeah, will also then be not possible. So even if that occurs in the winter time, it's very dramatic, because then it will occur that there are many, many, many people dying because of vitamin this efficiency, I don't know what it is. Vitamin lack of vitamins, yeah, lack of vitamins. Yeah. And interesting enough, that one of the premier and one of the most interesting books that Mr. Bill Gates reads is the book from Daryl Huff called "How to Lie with Statistics." You see, they're talking right in your face, but many people don't believe it because they just don't care. They're just following orders. They're just they cannot do their own research. They're just too lazy or too occupied. I don't know. Yeah. So I found a very interesting quote today, which I have to translate into English. So I'm using here DeepL, because I have found out that DeepL is capable of translating much more words than Google. So George Washington has been claimed that he said the quote, "The need to save the world is almost always just a false front for a need to rule the world." So the people who have been putting out in front that you always do just want your best, maybe want your life.
Sounds like an admission from a Jesuit actor mm-hmm. himself.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mr. George Washington.
Yeah, he was at least a Freemason. We know that, huh?
Oh, he's Jesuit for sure.
Yeah. Yeah, so many people, and we know that all the space and all the things about the space and it's just coming from the Jesuits. Yeah, the Jesuits are actually the big conspiracy. Yeah, everybody says that, yes. Oh, we are the conspiracy loonies. No, we are just pointing the finger to the real conspiracy. And the conspiracy is the satanic mindset, the satanic spirit which deceives people. And this is the conspiracy, because they are all conspiring
who follow and are led by the god of this world, Michael, yeah, are the ones yeah. that are blaming us.
Yeah, sure. You see that they twitch everything around.
Yeah, they do.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's the old concept in the Bible of the wheat and the tares.
Yeah,
the sheep and the goats.
They try to sell us these people as enlightened ones. Yeah, cannot tell you which way the earth is rotating, but they tell us these are the professors, these are the professed ones, these are the wise guys. I'm sorry, but this is my role model here, because I found that so hilarious. I pointed that out in the Foucault pendulum sessions. Yeah. So that people actually are being fascinated by science, and they don't try to question authority. Yeah, it's like in the movie from They Live, from Carpenter, with the Rowdy Roddy Piper as the main character, when he's putting up the glasses and then sees the people like reptiles or like aliens or so, and he sees then the big advertisement in They Live. I talked about it in English. Do not question authority. Do not question authority. Yeah, do not question authority. It's the main key. Yeah, the government has experts in that field. Yeah, scientists most likely. Yeah, or generals, but scientists. Do not question authority. Yeah, and so people come up with a big, big display of a giant Foucault pendulum, and this guy is so fascinated that he even slept the entire night to have the movement of that ball, of that pendulum, in his camera. And these people are so fascinated by science that they don't question the authority. He's in a big museum or where else, I think it was in Paris or so, I don't know. Yeah, and nobody will question the authority, yeah, because you are being manipulated by the school system that you don't question the authority, because the authority are the wise guys, and these are the guys, the teachers, the professors, who give you then good grades if you follow and obey the rules. But it does not have anything to do with the truth, yeah. Have an electromagnet on top, huh, interesting. Maybe he's got also electromagnet on the bottom, huh? Who knows? Who knows? So they are capable of much more things that you would even dream of. Yeah, so the things that they are pointing out in their movies, like Number Five or Wall-E, yeah, from Peter Gabriel, yeah, this is real stuff nowadays. Yeah, this is real stuff. The next step to the moon. Because when in the Second World War Germany was losing, they picked up all these excellent scientists from Germany, and they handed them over, part of them to the Soviet Union for their space program, and part of them to the United States by the very official Operation Paperclip. Some 350 German scientists and former intelligence agents were given visas and well-paying jobs. So instead of saying that, oh, there were National Socialists, Nazis, followers of the Third Reich who had been busy with forced labor and all the things. No, they were given visas and well-paying jobs. So it depends on if you are of use, if they got a purpose for you in the new world, so to speak, as of the United States of America. Once again, former intelligence agents were given visas and well-paying jobs. Many of these scientists had questionable pasts. Brown, speaking of Wernher von Braun, the chief of the agency, of the space agency in your country, United States, himself had been an active member of the Nazi party, and his colleague as the NASA, Dr. Hubertus Struckholt, a specialist in aviation medicine, had performed experiments on concentration camp inmates. But who cares? Because it's just for the greater good. Huh? It is absolutely for the greater good. So it has nothing to do with truth. It has something to do with, are you of use? Yeah. The best example I am aware of is the general major of the German Wehrmacht, of the German army of the Third Reich, Mr. Reinhard Gehlen, who was then, maybe they got it in English, it's much more easier for me, yeah, a German lieutenant general, intelligence officer, chief of the Wehrmacht Foreign Army's East Military Intelligence Service, so secret service, during the World War II. Then afterwards, he was being deported to the United States as a spy master of the CIA-affiliated anti-communist Gehlen Organization. And also he was busy, together with Wild Bill Donovan, to erect the structure of the CIA after the war. Yeah. And afterwards, he became the founding president of the Federal Intelligence Service of West Germany during the Cold War. So an ex-SS general becomes the founding president of the German Republic, here, West Germany, where I'm living here, yeah, without any problem. If you are important enough, you are over any, or you're standing above the jurisdictional court. Yeah, so some people can do everything. And Jörg always claims that in his biography, he claims that he is the founder of the Israeli Secret Service as well. Can you imagine? An SS officer is the founder of the Israeli Secret Service. We're speaking about Jews who had then been murdered in German concentration camps. Yeah, and one of the high-ranking Nazis is then founding member of the CIA and then founding member of the Israeli Secret Service. And you really think that it does matter what kind of color or what kind of uniform these people are wearing? It's just about power, so that if somebody has knowledge, special knowledge about things, he is useful, he will be used, and nevertheless, if he is a murderer or something else, it does not matter. You see that in the satanic world, it is do what thou wilt, and somebody who is absolutely reckless and very successful is highly rewarded. Yeah, of course, you can imagine what kind of order he was belonging to. Huh? Grand Cross of the Order Pro Merito Militensi of the Order of Malta. Yeah, these are the people shedding blood. It's easy, actually, but sometimes you will face the fact that you don't want to, yeah, that you don't want to understand it because you cannot imagine the world being that bad.
That's right. That evil.
It scares you also. It scares you because you see that the world is actually run by psychopaths, by sociopaths, by murderers, by these people. Yeah. So that is really the problem, that people don't see that. They don't see that. They don't want to see that. And when we approach the item of the Space Agency of the United States, we would have to look back. Because without the help of the German scientists, there would be no NASA. That's the point. So before we go into the NASA and all the so-called space travel and all the things, we have to go back. It's the same like in the science is the new religion thing. If you don't know what alchemy is, you don't understand what chemical things are. If you don't know what Jesuitical science is, you cannot comprehend Albert Einstein's work. So we have to go back once again. If we will really know, like to know, what's it all about with this so-called modern day and age and space travel and all about, we have to go back. We have to go back to a point where I don't think that you would realize that we have just talked about a teeny tiny bit. I think it was about 50 sessions ago. Yeah, that much we have to go back.
Ah, you're starting to remind me of Alberto Rivera when he was speaking about, you've got to go back.
Okay.
And when he was speaking about 1776 in the history of the United States, you know, you can't start there. That's the wrong place to start. Because it really started in 1492, didn't it, Michael?
Yeah.
Officially. 1492, Columbus sailed the ocean blue. Well, it probably started long before that. Yeah, you get to the Crusades. I was reading about that today a little bit.
They had to know which direction you see that. That is absolutely bogus in Christopher Columbus. Yeah, it's so hilarious that it was taught at my German school 50 years ago or 40 plus years ago that Christopher Columbus just was on the wrong way. Yeah, headed in the wrong direction. Yeah, I don't think so. Is it possible that he went across with voyages across the Atlantic Ocean? Yeah, four voyages across the Atlantic Ocean. You see here a map of it. Yeah, and you tell me that he didn't know where he was going. Yeah, the first voyage in blue. Yeah, so the first voyage in blue. You see here starting in Spain. Yeah, then going down south. And to discover India, he would have to, simply go straight forward to until here. But no, he made a right turn. Does that look like, we are just way off and we don't know where we are? It looks like a straight arrow here. Arrow. Yeah, not arrow, but arrow. ARROW. Yeah, boing. And there you go. Yeah, Cuba. Yeah, Fidel was not around in 1492. But that's the thing, that he would have been sailing here. You don't tell me that people did not sail until this. And if you know that he was carrying three ships with him, yeah, you don't tell me that all of the people on three ships could not navigate. That's what we have learned. Also, when I was in school, we have learned that there will be an ice age, an approaching ice age, and we will run out of oil.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah, and we will run out of oil soon. Yeah, it would also be sufficient.
Oh, yeah, peak oil. Yeah, I remember.
Yeah, yeah. We would also have been sufficient oil for a maximum of 40 years. That was 1975. Yeah, so nowadays, somebody speaking of not enough oil? I don't think so. First voyage. Yeah. His Santa Maria, the Holy Mary. Santa Maria. Huh? Voyages of Christopher Columbus. It's so great. I don't know who actually is believing this. I don't know. I really don't. first voyage. His ship is Santa Maria under Columbus' direct command. The other two were smaller caravels. The name of one is lost, but it is known by the Castilian nickname Pinta, the paint one. The other is the Santa Clara, another Santa, was nicknamed the Nina girl, perhaps in reference to his owner, etc. Yeah, so he was having three ships with him. This is a replica of the Pinta, yeah, so the smaller ship. But nevertheless, it's a ship, and that means that it's precious. So Christopher Columbus, as the absolute lunatic who cannot navigate, has then the order of the king to discover the New World. So there was nobody in Spain except Christopher Columbus. Yeah. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. That is science. That is history being taught. Yes. What people actually tell about history is to avoid the truth. Yeah, it's like in Tesla, when I look upon that, it has everything to do with the Russian Orthodox Church. Am I to believe that these people do not know how to pray, that these people do not know about spiritual exercises, when Tesla himself is reading a book of a famous Jesuit called Roger Boscovich? Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is the grave of Tesla's parents, actually. Yeah, this is absolutely unlikely. It's unlikely. These were important people. You see that on their gravestones. These are very important people. It's not the average John Doe, the milkman or something like this. No. These people have been selected and been used and misused. Yeah. And so that's the real problem here. This is the Marconi room at the Titanic. This is the broadcasting station. Yeah. And so there is a famous telegram, get off that ship from the provincial to Pater Brown. And that was an official order, get off that ship, official order from a provincial. So a Jesuit order, get off that ship, because they knew that it would drown. It had to drown. That was the only task of the Titanic, was that it had to drown. It had to drown certain people. It had to create an insurance scandal. And yeah, they got their money back. Yeah, so it's all a big game. Yeah? But you see that everybody plays the game of a different level. And Tesla played that game and said, okay, I'm not in for the money, I'm in for the development. I want to achieve certain things in the world, maybe for fame, but most likely because he was obsessed with his work, more or less. Yeah. So this obsession of the scientist, that he said, I received my signals from Mars. We are in the middle of space age. I mean, people said, "Oh, it must be possible to go to the moon. It must be possible to go to the stars. It must be possible to send rockets." Yeah, that was in the 1940s. But all these inventions that Tesla did, we do not know how many and how much and how efficient they were. So maybe there is a hidden science, which is, of course, not known to us, for military purposes. So we do not know what kind of weapons they have, what kind of propulsion engines, what kind of rockets, what kind of possibilities, for example, to hide things from our own eye. Huh? We do not know. What I know is that Tesla said, where is that? If you want to find the secrets of the universe, think in terms of energy, frequency, and vibration. So you must control these things when you want to control people. Also, you have to control energy. Because frequency and vibration, I came up with that thing. I said, well, okay, sorry. Energy is a fundamental physical proportion. Yeah. But what is frequency and vibration? When I put it in the context of our body, and of our Earth, I see there is something to it. Yeah, you see, there are certain frequencies. It's a low frequency, mid-range frequency, and high or treble frequencies. And what does the creation tell us? The creation tells us that the surface of the Earth has that size. In German, it's kilometer. That would be other way around. In American, you would have to divide it by 1.6 to get around 300 plus million kilometers. That's the surface of the Earth. That's been taught in the globe model, of course. Yeah, and from that, the amount of water on that Earth that we are living in is about 70%. Yeah, so that leaves 29.3% for dry land. Okay, so 70% of water is on the surface of the Earth. That is the official dogma. Yeah, we cannot prove it, of course. How? Yeah. So, but the human body also consists about 60 to 75% out of water. The amount of the water has been influenced by several factors like age and sex. A newborn have a amount about 75% and adults around 65%. But you see, that's quite clear to me that the Earth resembles the amount of water that average human adult also carries. Yeah, that for me, that was another sign that we are living on a unique Earth. Yeah, you got here a comparison sheet from young to old. So the amount of water in the body decreases slowly. That's also the reason why your skin looks crippled and you don't have the big muscles anymore, because muscles mainly contain of water that many people do not know. So the amount of water in the human body is dropping with age. Yeah, therefore you're not that flexible as you were when you were younger. But if you look at the creation also, it makes absolutely sense that we are living on Earth, which provides us also with all the things that we know. And we are living not in a hostile environment. We are living in a very friendly environment that nature even supports us with food. You see the amount of water in the organs of people. In the hairs, it's 10%, in the brain, 85%. So 85% of our brain is water. So can you imagine how important it is to drink water and how important it is to control the people, for example, with weather? Because when you control the weather, you can also control the water. For people who are living in a dry land or in a desert, ultimately important to control the weather. If you have something against people living in New Mexico or in some desert in Africa and it won't rain for 5 years, you got more than one problem. Yeah. In the bones, it's 22%, in the muscles, 75%, in the skin, 70%, in the blood, 83%, in the joints, 83%, in the kidneys, 83%, in the liver, 85%, in the lung, 84%, in the heart, 75%, and in the eyes, 99%.
99%.
Yeah?
Ow. Ow.
Yeah, you see, that is the main goal. You see, that if they want to control, I don't know if it was Rockefeller or somebody else who said, if you want to control the infrastructure, you have to control the resources of a state. But if you want to control the people, you have to control the food. And if somebody controls the weather, he will automatically also control the food. Because they control the harvest, they control the weather, they control the water, they control the rain, they control the conditions of the environment you are living in. Science in this world means Antichrist science. It is not restricted to being Jesuitical science. It means anti-Christian science. That means it is only promoted when it is against Christ, when it is against the creation of Christ, when it is against us. It's been used then against people. not for the benefit of people, against people. That's my conclusion when I think about the possibilities of controlling the weather in 2025 from the Air Force. You see, when you got a Department of Defense, you need an enemy. Because in the official doctrine, the Department of Defense is only then in charge when there is an enemy. Otherwise, you don't need to defend yourself against anything if there is not an enemy. So if they declare a country as an enemy or a certain, population as an enemy, yeah, they can try to control that enemy also with weather manipulation. If you think that is far-fetched, let's look into the future. Yeah, but the problem is, as we found out, that humor means together in John 3:5, that when Jesus says, except a man be born of water and spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. And the human body consists mainly of about 70% of water. So that means of body and spirit here, more or less. So you have to be born in this world, yeah, to enter the kingdom of God later. And that also means if the majority of brain is water, if they control the water, if you cannot drink enough water, or you drink polluted water, your brain function will be affected. Your spirit will be affected. In the case that somebody would control the weather or would control the environment, they will also control the people by dumping them down, because they don't supply them with the necessary elements, with the necessary water, with the necessary food, vitamins, etc. And some governments, or most governments, yeah, huma means spirit, water. Huh? Spirit, ma, water. We talked about that in the Freddie Mercury Queen sessions. I think that's not far-fetched that in regions where you don't have any fresh water, your health will be affected. Yeah? And also your mental health will be affected. Yeah. So that is not a nice topic to talk about, but I think it serves us that we know that if we want to go into the science, we have to think about that it is against people. Because in the Antichrist system, when it is against the creation of Christ, it's always against the people. It's just a few people who are the so-called elite, who are in the power, in charge, who have the money and the abilities to go into this. They can manipulate the people in plain Hegelian dialectic, and saying, in creating, for example, horrendous weather situations, and then coming up with their solution, the state can help you, but only if you hand over your rights and I don't know anything else in the, it's coming up in my mind, but I don't want to disturb you with many things which could come in the future. But these people are so powerful that they can create tremendous weather conditions, and then can blame it on,
Michael. One of the terms I don't think I've heard you use yet is geoengineering.
Yeah, geoengineering it is, more or less.
Yeah, that's the modern, the most up to date term for manipulating the weather.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, this was here a German script of music, the origin of music, and what's it all about, so that will not serve us yet now at the moment. Yeah, but the thing is that the human body is affected and consists mainly of water. So if you have a wave, yeah, then your water in your body, or you have a punch of a bass drum, then the water in your body will react. Yeah, because you are in vibration. What did Tesla say? When you want to know the secrets of the universe, you have to think in terms of energy, which would be the amplitude, frequency, and vibration. Yeah, that's it. That's it, actually. Yeah. So if you have water and you have music, then the water is swinging and producing certain waves. It's like if you just drop a stone into the water and you see that you see all the waves. So that's for that part of the lecture. So I highly think that it's highly likely that they will play with us with their so-called science, that they will try to manipulate people. And as Brett correct pointed out, we can name that geoengineering. Yeah, let's do it in English to close it down. English. Climate engineering. So I don't doubt any climate change, by the way. I know that climate is a general term for weather when you think it in a global scale.
Yeah, we're back to Pope Francis, aren't we?
And not only a global scale, but if you think about then reporting and not controlling, but noticing the weather in long-term periods, so for centuries, for decades or what, yeah, the climate is constantly changing. And so what they are talking about, oh, you're a climate denier here at the moment in Germany or in Europe on that occasion. It's absolutely hilarious because I'm not denying any climate. Yeah. Oh my. It's just you see that just to divide and conquer, yeah? Divide et impera, that's the strategy to divide the people into deniers, into approval, into what else? They're black and white, male and female, young and old, anti-vaxxers to vaxxers. Climate changers to climate deniers, and you see that it's the old game. It has nothing to do with truth. Yeah, and in the end, the agenda is winning because people are too busy to concentrate on the enemy and don't concentrate on the actual topic.
Well, yeah, Michael, it's almost as if, you know, God is actually behind all this, testing us all to see who are we going to stand with in the end? Are we going to stand with the little people that are going to be fighting against the corruption and the wickedness that's coming? Or are we going to be with the wicked? Are we going to be persecuting the small people that have no say in this society, because you just go with the flow, you know, and you end up persecuting the heretics. Mm-hmm. And, you know, if you're going to be heretical against the emperor or the pope, same thing. You're going to deny that we're living in the Roman Empire, too.
Yet been taught nowhere.
Except in our hearts, Michael, because God has written his law in our hearts.
Yeah, only
people figure it out.
Yeah, only elderly people
come to that knowledge. Yeah,
only elderly people can figure that out. And I think that's the main reason why they want to get rid of the elderly people, so that they can manipulate the younger people much more easily. Yeah, you see, they are bombarding them with their science, and so that you don't have any chance to correct that as long as these people are juveniles. Yeah, because they have to learn so many things, learning against learning, that they are absolutely not open for self-thinking, and they are only rewarded for obeying.
Bombarded with lies, Michael, straight out of the pit of hell. That's what this is.
Yeah.
It's a lie straight out of the pit of hell.
Climate engineering or geoengineering. Yeah. Who's the engineer?
Probably
the great architect. It's the great architect, maybe.
Yeah. The man of sin.
Yeah. Governance, huh? There you see. There you go. Governance.
Global governments, yeah.
Public good. Uh-huh. And you know where it all comes from, huh? You know where there's this
the greater good, yeah.
All yeah,
the glory of God, yeah. Which God? The God of this world, that's who
it is. Yeah, but it's a public good. You see, that geoengineering can be regulated to public good. I think that is, according to the papal bull.
Yeah, it's all Antichrist. Absolutely.
Yeah, I know, but I cannot recall the bull at the moment. What was it now? Caritas in Veritate, was it that? That was about the welfare. It was the other bull.
Oh, there's so many of them, Michael. We need to almost make like a... Is it Unum Sanctum?
No. No. This is much, much younger. They come up with the things then when they are in charge of that task. Yeah. So you see, they can manipulate everything in science, in medicine, in research, in power distribution. They can manipulate everything, and then they create the laws for that on the as a foundation, and then they have they will win every time because they know what will come. Yeah, but we as a people, we do not know what they will have in store for us the next time. So the only place we can rely on that is the Bible, and the Bible tells about that there will be famines, pestilences, earthquakes in diverse places. Yeah, you know, earthquakes, that's what to me came up, and I said, well, that's...
Well, pestilences, certainly, that's what we're going through right now, brother.
Yeah, so that well, I came up and I said, okay, this is one of the things, and there are some things missing. So then please expect to have some earthquakes in the future. Yet don't be aggressive towards me now when you're living in the Los Angeles area. Yeah, I cannot help it, but you see, that is the Bible speaking thousands of years before you even settled in the Los Angeles area. When it is affected on earthquakes. But what shall all the poor people in Japan say when they are constantly bombarded with earthquakes? Just the Bible speaks of it. And when the Bible is speaking of famines, yeah, then I say that maybe it has something to do with the climate control also, because then if you don't have any harvest, then people will starve.
Yeah, then they shall deliver you up to be afflicted and shall kill you, and you shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
At the moment, we are in a position where we can talk about that freely. I don't know if we get the position next year when many, many, many services are being controlled, or the majority of services being controlled, and that the Vatican said they will command or recommend the governments to take action against so-called fake news.
Mm-hmm.
So, okay. But fake news in the eyes of a satanic system, of course. Mm-hmm. In the eyes of Satan, it's a Satan, the Bible is fake news.
Of course.
Hmm? So you see, we've gone a long way, and even if you go into the weather, it's not nice. Huh? Because it's not natural, so everything will be manipulated against people. So that they think there is no God, because God would never allow to happen that much, big amount of earthquakes and all these catastrophes. But in the end, well, in the end, it's just a big game. And if you don't know the script, you absolutely lost, because you're just being manipulated from left to right, from one famine to the next pestilence, into an area where an earthquake is happening, wars, and rumors of wars. And the only war which is happening, actually, is in the minds of people. The war between the majority of people being the Antichrist spirit, where they are fighting for their so-called life here in that existence, against a few people of the Holy Spirit who just want to help and want to pray other people that they realize that they're being betrayed. They're being betrayed mentally. Yeah. So many people, also many scientists, are playing tricks on them, and people fell for that because they see these people as the experts, they see these people as the scribes and high priests. If science is the new religion, then the scientists are the priests. I think that's very logical. So these are the priests who are saying that you have to obey, that you have to put your money for this and you have to behave like this and then you will have a nice and happy life. Yeah, but scientists are the priests of today. Why? Yeah, look at Georges Lemaître, the one who came up with the Big Bang theory. He was a priest and a scientist at the same time. Yeah, a Catholic priest, a theologian, and astrophysicist. He's the founder of the Big Bang. I know that's German, but you see, it's the same thing around. Together with Albert Einstein once again, and for the last time, I hope. nothing against Einstein, you see that, but yeah. He was in the spotlight while nobody talked about Mileva, his wife. And nobody talked about Roger Boscovich. Yeah, sacred Boscovich. Sacre Bosco. Yeah, that was a character in the medieval times. Yeah, and you got it at the same, the scientist. Yeah, look at Teilhard de Chardin. Yeah, Teilhard de Chardin. The man in the cosmos. Teilhard de Chardin, Piltdown Man, the hoax. The fraud about the missing link between animals and humans or mankind, Piltdown hoax. Yeah. Piltdown man hoax. Yeah, that was a hoax. That was a fraud. It's just like the same fraud as some theory of relativity. Yeah. A fraud in which bone fragments were presented as the fossil remains of a previously unknown early human. Yeah, but they took Charles Dawson's claim that he found in 1912. Yeah, it was exposed in 1953 as a forgery. So that went on for 40 years. Now compare that to the actual situation out there. When that situation, Earth situation, occurred in 2020, you would realize in 2060 that it was all a fraud. Can you imagine? That's science.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Yeah, and later on there were other things going on. So Lucy as the missing link, huh? Lucy, yeah, Lucy as not the name, but Lucy as the missing link. Lucy, I don't know, as the ape, was it Lucy with Y? Yeah, it was with Y, yeah. So Lucy, commonly known as Lucy, a collection of several hundred pieces of fossil bone represented 40% of a female of the hominin species Australopithecus afarensis. Yeah, which never existed. Which never existed. Yeah, Lucy also is a short abbreviation of Lucifer, but nobody would go into this because people don't know the Bible and don't care about the Bible, don't believe in the Bible and are not in the spirit to go into this. Yeah. So you see, you got a timeline. A million years ago, something happened out of the blue. Yeah, and Lucy is also a fraud. Yeah, but the people are just want to believe that they are coming from apes because they will accept every explanation, Brett, as far as they don't have to obey any commandments of any god, so that they can be their god as their self, and with fornication, with lust, with terror, with murder, and they get away with everything. Yeah, that's great. How to feel yourself like a god. What better feeling is this, no? Yeah. So where to start? Where to start? It's been not officially known as fraud or fake or what? Unbelievable. Yeah. Yeah. You collect some bones and you say that, oh, I am the wise scientist. I am the priest of the new age and I declare this as the missing link. It happened 3.2 million years ago. With our carbon 14 method. Oh, yeah. which is so reliable that once the thing is 3 million years old, and then afterwards it's 200,000 years old. Lucy acquired her name from the song "Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds" by the Beatles. Yes, and then you have to ask Paul McCartney. Lucy was God, he said in our sessions of. I cannot remember. I think it was Christopher Lee with Paul McCartney and the Wings Band on the Run, where we went into the Beatles. Yeah, Lucy was God, said Paul McCartney. Of course, Lucifer. So please, then I have nothing to say because we cannot go into your one of your favorite things, maybe, because we have to go way back to go to this actual day and age. And when we go way back, you will be very surprised to learn the alternative history of your beloved space agency.
Oh, yes. We've been looking forward to this for a long time.
It's very easy, actually, but people won't believe it, because they are so blinded by worldly science that they really believe everything that the television is putting out.
Yeah. Well, they might believe it for a while, Michael, but... we're going to have to wrestle with them about the eternal consequences of believing this hogwash. Because, people say we have time, but yeah, how much time? God only knows.
I don't know.
No better time than the present.
What I can tell you that is the space travel and the space agency or the whole space thing is the most relaxed item of all the upcoming sessions of Science is a New Religion. There will come sessions that you maybe think that, oh, I've better not see this, or I don't know, because it absolutely will spoil your appetite. But that is science. Science is against people. It's hilarious that people nowadays really think they can civilize the moon and live civilize the Mars and live there. Sorry, there are no trees. There is no water. You would have to create an artificial world. But I don't know. Sometimes it really escapes me how betrayed people are, that they don't have anything left of common sense. Maybe is that the only agenda, that people don't have any common sense and believe everything out of their television set. And people are heavily relying on television today. It's unbelievable. Okay, Sam, please close it down because I need to sleep very soon. And I'm glad that you participated, Brett, and all the audience out there. Next time, I really promise that you will see many, many pictures and many, many interesting stuff around that, and even more interesting history, because if you don't know what happened yesterday, you cannot prophesy the things, or you cannot know the meaning of today, and you won't prophesy the outcome. But if you know what the intention is, if you got the foundation, then you actually see what's all about, and that is nothing to do with the story which is presented to you in the mainstream. Nothing, absolutely nothing. So you will be very surprised maybe to go back to an earlier session when it all started somewhere else. Thank you for having me. Please read your Bible. God bless, and hang it over to my beloved brother Brett.
Thank you, Michael. You know, it's really interesting, you know, when you take the time to start asking some of your own questions and researching the answers out for yourself, and you'll also find that when you start reading the Bible will start presenting words and definitions and things that you may not have considered before. And it's incredible, you know, how God teaches us through his word. I'll just give you an example in Matthew chapter 6. I'm going to read verses 19 through 24 right now. Lay not up for yourselves treasures upon earth, where moth and rust doth corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal. But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust doth corrupt, and where thieves do not break through nor steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will your heart be also. The light of the body is the eye. If therefore thine eye be single, thy whole body shall be full of light. But if thine eye be evil, thy whole body shall be full of darkness. If therefore the light that is in thee be darkness, how great is that darkness? No man can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. Ye cannot serve God and mammon. Thanks for listening. We'll catch up with you next time. Maranatha.